Well, the van is back, and look, it's painted. It looks really nice. It no longer looks like a word that I can't say on YouTube. Yeah, no, I had it painted, as you can see now. Last video, I think I was showing you all the prep and everything that was being done. I had a cold as well. Now I remember it, yeah. But yeah, it's looking really nice. It's in Ford Frozen White, which is a really, really bright colour that I've always liked. Modern colour. Yeah, there it is. You can actually see against that old panel there, which I asked them not to paint because this one's getting replaced. You can actually see the whiteness difference. Like, that paint there is the original white and it's in good condition, that bit. That's how I was hoping it would look when I eventually had it painted, but now it's even better. It's really white. It's very nice. It's got a lovely shine to it, as you can see. And not all of them, but left a couple of dents, as you can see, intentionally, because I want people to realise this van does have a history. But the big dents and things have been removed, as you can see. It's got a lovely shine on it now. And it hasn't even been polished yet. Still got quite a few bits to do to the exterior. Obviously I've got the doors and stuff to put back on. The doors are still in the paint shop. This piece here, I'm gonna paint this myself. I'm gonna do this a nice metallic black. They've done all the door shuts and everything as well, which is nice. Yeah. Honestly, it looks a lot better than I expected it would. It looks like really, really nice. I'm very, very happy with it. It's just the shine it's got, and the new roof and everything just looks really good now. The bottom half of along here, this bit I think will be eventually going black. Not sure yet, I'm not fully decided, but it has been coated with Gravitex, which is basically the same as Raptor Coat, as you can see. And this is just like a really thick rust preventative stuff. Because, yeah, I had to re-weld all this and I don't want to do it again. And you can see at the back where the bumpers will be mounted as well. That's all done. And of course, I'll be doing the wheels. I'll be having those powder coated as well in anthracite, which is a deep metallic-y grey colour. Same colour as the wheels on my Skoda. But yeah, exterior basically done now. Still got to do the interior. I think I mentioned all these panels were getting replaced with good ones, which I now have in stock. So I got these off Sean, who is the LDV guru, who I guess people with LDVs know him. Nice guy. And he has new parts and old stock as well, all sorts of bits and pieces. And yeah, went to his place and pulled some nice trim panels out of another minibus. All the interior trims, and even got some storage lockers as well. These are the ones that mount in the roof. I'll just go around the other side so you can see them better. Kind of a bit nervous to go around the van because it's the paint's just so good. But yeah, these are the overhead storage lockers. So I'll put a picture up of what they'll look like as well. But yeah, all the trims and everything here in basically new condition. The doors and everything, as I mentioned, they're still in the paint shop. You'll see them when they're all fitted and everything. But I've also got new rubbers and things as well. headrests. This actually, this white thing, is actually a brand new seat to go in the back to replace that one. Don't know if I can actually show it because it's all quite well buried. There you go. Brand new. Never been sat on. Well, I sat on it and it was very comfy. New trim panels for the doors, for the back doors, I should say. All the glass and everything there to go back in. Anything else worth showing? Not really. It's very, very dusty in here now. Honestly, it looks like there's someone's had like a crazy cocaine adventure. In fact, it probably has actually. This van's got a very weird past. It used to be owned by a church in Ireland. And then I bought it off a hippie. But anyway. these are the rear doors. As you can see. And you want to know another fun thing is this door and the other one that's under here, they're brand new. There we go. I decided to go for solid doors on the back. Long story short is, couldn't find any decent window doors. The doors that came off the van had a bit of surface rust and were starting to rot, and I just thought I'd rather spend a bit of money and get decent ones. So I got these off Sean. This one was literally brand new, never been fitted to a vehicle. And that one had been on a van for about 6 months, so it was basically brand new. Both are like solid rust-free doors, as you can see. Lovely. I will be rust proofing all the inside of it, cavity waxing it all. But yeah, really good. I'm very happy with it. But yes, very, very excited. It's been a massive morale boost, you could say, because I was getting to the stage where I was not getting fed up of it, but seeing it looking like crap all the time, it just didn't really, how do you say, inspire me. But now that it looks decent, ready to crack on with it a bit more. The only problem is I can't because I've got work the upcoming week or so, but that's okay. The joy is being self-employed. But yeah, once I've blasted through all the work, I'll get back on it and start putting the windows in, putting the doors on, putting the guts into the doors as well, because obviously I gutted them. I've got, as I mentioned, new rubbers for going around the windows. Like, not these ones, but the windows that are in the doors, like the little triangular ones. Can't actually see them, but they are buried in that bag there. This is literally just a pile of new LDV bits. Even got these. These actually came out of a mini coach, one with a walk-in door, because I kind of wanted, hang on, find the other one, this one here, to replace that bit of trim in that corner there, due to the fact the original LDV ones are very prone to cracking up and going brittle. But for some reason, these ones out of mini coaches, which end up deleting the grab handle due to the fact it's a mini coach and literally has a walk-in door here, these ones are actually in far better quality plastic. So yeah, these ones don't crack and go brittle. So there's, unless you drop it. So yeah, there's a bit of interesting, boring information for you. But yeah, once it's all, as I say, rebuilt back together, I'll be then getting it polished and waxed and everything, so it'll literally be a mirror shine on an LDV Convoy Minibus. So there we go. Don't think there's anything else to say. Actually, yes, there is. This panel, as I mentioned, is getting replaced because it's actually bent slightly. used to have to slam the bonnet to make it shut, and then I realised it's, for some reason, it's just not right. So that's getting replaced, hence the reason I mentioned not to paint it. But also the engine bay, all this metal here which is red, because it's been red oxided, this is all going to get done in Raptor as well, the Raptor coat. But I'm going to do it in black. Same with all the inner wings, so it'll be just a jet black textured finish. Does mean I'm going to have to lift that out again, which is actually a bit of an arse to do, but never mind. Just with the pipes. Originally the ABS pump was just like hanging, because all this metal had rotted away. So it was just like chilling there. You could get to it through under the wheel arch, which is not really ideal. You could say the ABS pump had left the chat. But yeah, there you go. That's how it is just now. And once I crack on with it a bit more, I'll make some more videos. But unfortunately, I've got, as I mentioned, work coming up, so I'm not going to be able to do as much. But get it all built back up, get the interior done. A few bits of wiring to go in, because I'm putting a nice sound system in. I've already replaced the speakers and stuff. Gonna run an amplifier and subwoofer and everything as well. A stealthy but powerful system, same as what's in the Skoda. Got a DAB stereo there, albeit a very dusty one. I think I'm gonna have to go over everything with a Hoover again. But yeah, there you go. Thanks for watching.